Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and in this lesson we are going to look at what I call as melodic arpeggios, a technique to basically play arpeggios in a melodic manner or bring out the melody while focusing on the arpeggios, sort of two for the price of one, if you will. And arpeggios normally will be chords which we move in a flowing manner. In this lesson I've taken four chords, which I have done in pretty much a lot of the lessons in the past. We've taken E minor, G major, D major, and A major. So what you normally do is you'll be playing it as an arpeggio, and I have done commonly used arpeggio patterns, which I've also covered and taught. This video is about taking that to the next level, okay, and playing it in a very, very unique and original flavor sounding way. So what was once something very common, high, middle, low, middle, right? You can now make it sound a bit more melodic. Right? Something like that. So I'm gonna, the whole lesson is based on starting with something we know, an arpeggio pattern we already know, and then figure out a way with just some simple concepts to kind of bring out the melody line of whatever you want to play. So for this lesson, we're basically going to deal with E minor, G major, D major, and A major. I've used these chords a lot in the past, right? I like them. It sounds very brave and epic. So E minor, G major, D major, A major. You can play like this or like this. And now what we do with melodic arpeggios is we need to start with a phrase or start with a pattern which begins from the top note of the arpeggio. So maybe create an arpeggio pattern which starts from the top. For example, high, middle, low, middle, or else high, low, middle, low. What chord am I playing? E minor. So I could do, start like that, high, middle, low, middle, high, or else high, low, middle, low, high, low, middle, low. Okay, get used to this. And now we are going to move things around. So this is E minor, right? So if we just focus on E minor, we could look at the top note and just keep moving it till wherever we can. See, I can't move it all the way. I have human limitations. So I could do something like this. So it's actually becoming very melodic right there because it's spelling out la ra re. And what am I doing here with my left hand? With my left hand, I'm doing something really interesting, right? But very simple at the same time. I'm taking E, which is my tonic in this case. The scale, by the way, I'm following an E Dorian scale, which is quite interesting. Which is like an E minor with a raised sixth. Right? E, F sharp, G, A, B, C sharp, D, E, D, C sharp, B, A, G, F sharp, E. Okay, so if I start with something very common like high, middle, low, middle, what do I do then? Float the high note. So that's the high note, and it goes all over the bandwidth of where your hand can manage in the first place. So you go high, high, middle, low, middle. And now start changing it. Okay. B, D, C sharp, A. B, E, C sharp, D. B, D, F sharp. I wish I could play that, but it's too high and too difficult for me. So B, D, C sharp, A. Yeah. Accompany this with your left hand. Start with maybe an E, a bass E. What's nice about this technique is you don't even need to play another chord. You have enough of information because you're floating around the top note, and the bass note could also float. For example, stay on E, maybe play a C, D. A. C. A. It's just E minor. That's the power of the bass. So as you can see, we've taken a very simple chord, E minor, floated the top note, floated the bottom note, the left hand is also moved, and we've created our song pretty much, if you think about it. So it's a really simple technique. You just start with a chord, take the high note, move it around as much as you can, start with a low note, which could be the root of your song, in this case E or E Dorian, and then move it around and see what options you can come up with, and look at the story you're also trying to tell in your composition. So now this particular chord progression has more chords. There are still more chords. So we have E minor, G major, D major, A major. So you see how the sky is the limit here, right? With just E minor, you've done so much. And if you watch some of the earlier lessons on our arpeggio techniques, or unique arpeggio techniques, you'll find that we've looked at accents, we've looked at clave, we've looked at the Latin rhythms, we've looked at subtraction arpeggios, where you looked at pattern arpeggios. We've done quite a few unique techniques for arpeggio playing. But if you bring all of that into this super unique technique, you get something which has to be your very own sound, right? While playing arpeggios. And that's really what I want you to gain from this lesson. So if I take, let's say, an accented phrase like a 3, 3 and a 2 with E minor. Okay, maybe change it. But the whole point of this lesson is just to see what we can do with one chord, and then you can do it for the other chords. So, okay. So what did I do there? I took high, middle, low, the same movement. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. But the high note kept floating. Still 3-3-2, isn't it? Immediately you create a melodic phrase. So what have I done there? I've taken 3-3-2. I can do it with accents. I can do any of the patterns which I've mentioned in the earlier videos, which you should check out if you haven't already, and use that in a melodic context. So if you take just this one chord, E minor, there are so many opportunities, right? So let me just have some fun for a few seconds and just play this, and you'll observe the top note floating around. I'm not giving you something exact to play, but I'm just giving you an approach. So the general approach, if we have to recap, will be the top note starts the arpeggio. So high, middle, low, or high, low, middle. Focus on that top note. That is your melody line. That has to be spelt out for your composition. the low note in the left hand can just be, can start by playing the chord root. The chord root of E minor is obviously E, right? And then you start floating the left hand as you wish, diatonically, of course. You don't want to play random stuff. And then you float the right hand as you wish, diatonically, of course. So you go... Even if you change just the bass, it can be quite interesting. Now float the high note. Right, make it rhythmically interesting with some accents. You can do a lot of stuff, so I'd advise you to practice it in a way not to perfect the music or the job at hand, but practice it with a keen sense of wanting to make something happen, wanting to make music, wanting to make a song, right? And it'll be great if you can. Right, guys, again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Hope you found this lesson on melodic arpeggios useful. I hope you can use it in your music, make some songs. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment, if you will, and spread our channel to all your musician friends. We'd love to grow, and we can only grow with your help and support. Cheers, and catch you in the next one.